haven't seen the puppies yet.
No.
I've been hearing about them.
I'm in the heart of the city, the core of the Big Apple, the epicentre of the known universe, New York.
Yeah, I'm up at Brooklyn, now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the narrow, but I'll be hood forever.
I've been summoned here by one of the greatest voices in music, the songbird supreme, Miss Mariah Carey.
Why are you so obsessed with me?
Mariah's got a new album out called Memoirs of an Imperfect Angel, and she's invited me to New York. Just called me up. Hey, Rick, come to New York. We're going to hang out. And it didn't happen like that. But the point is, I'm here, and I'm real excited. So, I'm sitting here with the woman that has had the most number one singles for a solo artist in the United States, has 5 Grammys, has sold over 200 million albums. 200 million! It's Mariah Carey. Mariah Carey.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Rick? I'm well, thank you. How are you?
I'm good.
Thanks so much for inviting me here.
Well, it's good to see you. Good to have you.
It's better to see you. we just saw you Wow Vegas. I know you've heard this 1,000 times before, but the voice, incredible.
Thanks.
From me to you, a fact. Tell us a bit about the new album. The title is Memoirs of an Imperfect Angel. From where I'm sitting, everything looks quite perfect.
I'm really excited about letting the fans hear this new album because it tells several stories. That's why it's Memoirs of an Imperfect Angel. I think that my life is very different now and it's translated to a change in my music. I think there's a lot of fun, honest love songs, a lot of just passion in what I'm doing now.
You're not just a lady who's got a great set of pipes. The acting bug, I guess, has never left you. And you've got a new film out, which has been getting rave reviews, Precious, where you play the social worker to a young girl. Doesn't sound that glamorous.
It's very unglamorous. I play a social worker who tries to help this young girl named Precious, who's been abused by both her parents, and she's already had 2 babies by the time she's 16, and she's illiterate. It's a very tough thing. And I totally transformed physically for the role.
Yes, you do. You won't mind me saying you don't look your best in the film.
You know I look amazing in it. No, this guy came up to me at the Toronto Film Festival and he's kind of like, he's a makeup artist, goes, honey, you look so ugly in the movie. But it was a compliment. And I was
it's
like,
it's a big compliment.
Thank you.
I love it when people say that to me. you mentioned that Precious showed at the Toronto Film Festival. Yeah. I trusted you to make a T4 diary. We're going to take our first look at Carey Cam.
Okay.
If we can. Here it is.
We've just come from Vegas. I'm doing a day of interviews and such for the movie Precious. And I was doing my concert last night and I had a very good time. Fabulous audience, darling. We haven't slept.
Okay,
so Louise is clapping her hands. It's a really, really unannoying trait that she has. Right now we're going to the press conference.
Right, Mariah takes on the first task of the day. Through a wall of paparazzi and into the film's star-studded press conference as Oprah Winfrey kicks things off.
You know, a film like this comes along once in a time. I mean, I don't think any of us have ever seen anything like this.
No, it was somebody that does makeup for me. They said, this is a Mariah Carey nightmare. You have everything that you hate going on right now.
Straight out of the press conference for a quick cast photo opportunity. You're making it faster, stronger. And then another photo shoot, this time for a magazine.
Yeah, there you go. That's perfect. Yeah, this is so great.
A quick stop to sign 100 movie posters.
This is called abuse. They're abusing me. It hurts.
This ain't completely easy.
Another quick touch up.
When you're awake for 60 hours, we like a full fill.
It's going to be fun.
Then it's into a small room and a start of 30 press interviews.
This is Ashley from Fox. Lynn Carter from Independent Film Channel.
Congratulations.
Yes.
It is a pleasure to meet you.
Hi there.
How are you?
It's like a million people in here.
Hi.
Hey, how are you?
Rosie from BT Canada.
We're doing good.
Five hours later, it's back to the hotel for a change, and yep, another touch-up.
It wasn't the press conference that was the thing. It was
Rachel?
The interviews afterwards. They take a long time. But I'm not going to sit here and complain, you know, because then they'll be like, she complained about having to do interviews. Oh, look at my dog just strolling by. My puppies are mating, and it's very, it's a difficult time for them. So I'm going down to the premiere now, and we're gonna take some pictures probably in the broad daylight. My favorite. It's a red carpet, it needs to be at night. Who didn't get the memo on this? Red carpet, nighttime, flash bulbs, they go off. That's what I like.
And it's off to a pre-screening press cocktail party. It's one of those evenings where everybody wants a little bit of Mariah.
I'll see you there.
Where's my car?
Actually, you want to come with me?
Right here.
After a slight transport confusion, it's off to the screen. And yes, it's another red carpet and more questions.
Is that this?
Lord, it's a good thing Lee is here.
Here.
Oh my goodness.
Until finally, 41 hours later, Mariah calls it a day.